kadının nasıl olması gerekir sorusuna cevabım şöyle olur. Mümin bir kadın Allah'a aşığıdır. Yani deli aşıktır. Kendini tamamen Allah'a teslim etmiştir. Dünya çıkarlarından tamamen kendini kurtarmıştır. Hırstan ve şikaktan, kıskançlıktan, hasetlikten kurtulmuştur. Mesela kıskanç bir kadının yüzü kirlenir, kararır. Yani kötü olur bakışları falan. Bir
My answer to the question of what a devout woman should be like is that she is in love with Allah, meaning that she has totally surrendered herself to Him. She has entirely freed herself from worldly concerns, from greed, discord, envy, and jealousy. For example, a jealous woman's face will be dirty and dark, in other words, not very nice. A lack of light emanates from her face. Greedy woman has no internal richness. In other words, Allah withdraws the majesty from her face. Because what we call woman is that profound power in her soul, not the flesh and blood. Because everyone, even horses and donkeys, have two front and rear legs. All animals have them. There is a deep force in the soul, a power stemming from moral virtue as a miracle from Allah. And that's what we call woman. And it's what which affects believers. It's that which cannot be described, but which we see as love of Allah. Think of a woman who says she is jealous, who envies and fights, who has worldly greed. She says that she can still be beautiful, but let her go and look in the mirror. She is not really beautiful at all. Her soul can never be beautiful. She can never find joy, and she can never find passion. She can never find the beauty of being a woman. So the man will be unaffected by her. Allah bestows coldness on such people's soul. Whatever they do, they cannot attain that beauty. They can make themselves up as much as they like, wear what they like, and behave as they like. But that repulsion and darkness in their souls will still be upon them. It's the same with men. Men can pretty themselves up all they like, wear what they like, and do whatever they want, but even if they become greater than 2 meters in height, they will still have no impact on a woman. In other words, so long as a woman sees that stupidity, that greed, that great distance from Allah and that darkness in the soul, he will never be able to establish a link with that power in her soul. She's not affected by him in the slightest. But a believer absorbs like a sponge absorbing the believer opposite. A believer soaks up love and passion, and that's what we describe as love between husband and wife. Not as in a limited company established to achieve small personal gains. That means just sorrow and suffering. It's mutual. One may take a pretty woman just to show her off to one's friend. What a degrading thing to do, to show one's wife off in public just to achieve a social success. A woman may marry a handsome man just to enjoy a success and make her friends envious and say, what a good-looking man she married. In such a painful environment, both envy and jealousy arise, there is mutual suffering and the dimness of soul arises, and one party regards the other party as a dull. That's one sees the other party as an empty log and feels the emptiness in the other soul. That emptiness creates a hitherto unknown repulsion. Yes. No matter what they do, they cannot get rid of it. They then decide to get divorced. But there are many times more people who would like to get divorced but do not. In other words, they have a constant subconscious wish to divorce, and the number of people who are unable to make it a reality is many times greater. For example, and I see this in films, the man comes home and tries to kiss the woman on the back of her neck. The woman is repelled and disgusted by that, but doesn't let on. Or the woman comes and embraces the man, but the man finds her repellent, is disgusted to think that such an entity is embracing him. But if they look at matters with faith and taqwa, as a manifestation of Allah, then a special power bestowed by Allah enters the equation. One we refer to as the sixth sense, relationship between a man and a woman. That's why people resort to various means to overcome that coldness. They go down all kinds of strange paths. They go to magic men to have spells lifted off them. They take drugs and use special lotions and go to the doctor for treatment. There are doctors who specialize in this field, as you know. There are famous doctors who have made their name in it. But these are not problems that can be resolved with doctors, professors, magic men, putty or special drinks. These are delights that come with faith, passion, profound intelligence and love of Allah.